हेलो फ्रेंड, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज द इलास्टिसिटी? मींस हाउ मच चेंज परसेंटेज चेंज इन क्वांटिटी डिमांड हाउ मच चेंज इन प्राइस मींस इलास्टिसिटी. इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड मींस द डिग्री ऑफ रिस्पॉन्सिवनेस ऑफ क्वांटिटी डिमांडेड फॉलोइंग अ चेंज इन प्राइस ऑफ द कमोडिटी मींस elasticity of demand. It is calculated by using this formula. Elasticity of demand is equal to percentage change in quantity demanded to the percentage change in price. Then next, the types or degrees of elasticity of demand. First, elastic demands, then inelastic demands, then unit elastic elasticity of demands, perfectly elastic demand, and perfectly inelastic demand. One by one discuss. First, elastic demand means the demand is said to be elastic if change in price causes more than proportionate change in quantity demanded, means elastic demand. For example, a change in price causes quantity demand by more than proportionate change in quantity demanded. For example, normally demand is elastic for luxury goods. Let's the price of gold per gram decline from rupees 160 to 140. As a result, demand for gold rises from 1000 kilograms to 2000 kilograms. Means, since elasticity of demand for gold is greater than 1, the gold is a luxury items. And next one is inelastic demand. When the change in price causes a less than proportionate change in quantity demanded, the demand is inelastic. Suppose a drop in a price of wheat from rupees 40 per kilogram to the rupees 20 per kilograms. The demand for wheat rises from 1600 kilogram to the 2000 kilogram. This is means the wheat has an inelastic demand, since the elasticity of demand is less than 1. And wheat is the necessarily articles, means inelastic demands. And next one is the unit elasticity of demand, means suppose the price of commodity declined from rupees 200 to rupees 100 per kilogram. As the result, the demand for the commodity rises from 400 kilogram to 800 kilograms, means simply the change in quantity to change in price equal to 1. Then perfectly elastic demand means when a slight change in price causes a great change in quantity demanded, the value of elasticity of demand tends to be infinity, and demand is said to be infinite or perfectly elastic. For example, under the perfectly competitive markets, the demand curve for a product of an individual firm become perfectly elastic. Next is the perfectly inelastic demands. If the quantity of demanded becomes completely unresponsive to price changes, the coefficient tends to be zero. In this case, whatever the price, even if it is zero, the quantity demand will remain fixed at a particular levels. The demand curve becomes parallel to the vertical axis, and demand is said to be completely inelastic. Then the factors determine the elasticity of demand. First, the nature of commodity means in first place the it depends on the nature of commodity. Commodities which are supposed to be essential on or critical to our daily life must have inelastic demands. Since the price change of these items does not bring about the greater change in quantity demand, but in luxury goods have an elastic demand, the demand for these goods can be quickly reduced when their prices rise. When their price falls, consumer demand these goods is larger quantities. Then availability of substitute means the large number of substitute must have an elastic demand, means the some products such as Horlicks, Complan have a quite a large number of close substitutes. A change in price Horlicks, the prices of other substitute remain the constant, will lead to consumer to substitute one beverage for another's. Then extent of uses means some commodity which can be used a variety of purposes. For example, electricity. If price per unit electricity consumed falls, people will reduce their consumption of its substitutes. For example, coal, gas, and increase the consumption of electricity. Then habit goods means some commodity consumes out of habits and conventions. They have an elastic demand, means for example even in a face of rising prices of those commodity or falling income, people will consume those, such as then time dimension means the shorter the time, lower will be the elasticity of demand, means this is because in the short run satisfactory substitute of product may not be available. The demand for a product in the short run usually become inelastic. Such commodity will be elastic in long run and when close substitute may be produced. Then the importance of being importance means the people often pay little attention to the price of a product if it constitutes a relatively small parts in their budget. For example, if the fare of railway ticket of tourists who travel by rail once in a year is increased from 125 to 130, then he may not postpone his journey. This means he is unresponsive to such price hike and his demand is inelastic. And then next factors determine the durability, means durable commodities have an elastic demand. If the price of these goods rises, people will spend less on these goods. On the other hand, following a fall in the price of durable commodities, for example refrigerator, the people demand more of them. In case of non-durable commodities, demand is elastic. Thank you.